Welcome to the second video in the Acontis EtherCAT main device software implementation guide video series. Throughout these videos, we will cover what is involved in developing an EtherCAT main device controller based around the Acontis EtherCAT solutions EC Master, EC Engineer, and EC Simulator. Some familiarity with the Acontis EtherCAT products is expected, so please check out our other videos for more in-depth product tutorial videos. In this video, we will dive into the software development and integration of EC Master, covering the software architecture of an application built on EC Master, the details of the included example application structure, and the execution flow of the application. EC Master Demo is the name of the main example application included with EC Master. This example shows how to initialize the master and set the network into the operational state. The example application relies on the EtherCAT network information file to enable support of all EtherCAT subdevices and customizations of those subdevices. The EC Master core library and the remote access server module are implemented in C++. The API interfaces of the core library and RAS module are C language interfaces, enabling the main device application to be developed in ANSI C and C++ environments. The application includes a logging class that outputs log messages to the console and stores them in a log file. When you first extract the EC Master software, you will find various files and folders structured in a specific way to aid in development and compiling. A section of modules is intended to be left as is, and a section is intended for developers to customize. The modules that should be left as is are in the SDK and sources folders. They include the header files and libraries, as well as some helper modules for creating threads and queues. In the customizable area under the examples folder, you will find some common files for the application parameters, notification handle, and logging. There's also a folder specific to the operating system that includes the main application entry point and other OS-specific functionality like threading and timing. The main area that developers will focus on is in the specific example applications, like EC Master Demo, that show how to work with the EC Master API and build EtherCAT applications using the library. Now let's look at the execution flow of an example application in more detail. The file ecdemomain.cpp contains the entry point for the application. In this file, there is some basic initialization and then the timing task is created. The timing task is specific to the operating system that the main device is implemented for. Then we call the ecdemoapp function, the implementation of which is in the file ecdemoapp.cpp. In this function, there will be numerous function calls beginning with the prefix myapp. These myapp functions allow the developer to insert code specific to the application being developed. First, a notification handler routine is set up, and then the myapp init function is called for any custom code related to the application's initialization. Then, the remote access server is started, followed by the API call to initialize the master core and open an Ethernet network interface. At this point, the job task can be created. In this function, all of the application's cyclic aspects are implemented, like processing the received frames, calculating new process data values, and sending the frames to the network. The job task function is triggered cyclically by the previously created timing task with a configurable time period. After the job task is created and set up, the rest of the application proceeds with configuring the network from the ENI file, registering the application with the library to receive notifications, scanning the network for subdevices, and then printing information about the subdevices found on the network to the console. At this point, the custom application can be prepared and set up to align with the EtherCAT state machine transitions from init to pre-op, safe-op, and ultimately the operational state. Now it is up to further development for how to proceed based on the specific application needs. The application will continue to run indefinitely based on the cyclic execution of the job task functions running in the timing task. This example can be shut down from the command line, which will trigger the safe shutdown procedure to stop the job task, unregister the application, stop the RAS server, and free up allocated resources and devices. The next step is to compile the example application yourself. Information about how to do this can be found in Chapter 2 of our EC Master User Manual, which we have linked to in the description. For more details and assistance with EC Master, check out our other videos in our EC Master tutorial playlist and our documentation, which are also linked below in the description. Thanks for watching, and hopefully this second video in our EtherCAT Main Device Implementation Guide series helps you get further along in your development of an EtherCAT Main Device controller based on the Acontis EC Master software. Stay tuned for our upcoming videos in the series, which will cover more topics related to main device software development and testing. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them below, or you can contact us on our website.